24 hours earlier, this mall, situated in Jahi area of the FCT, was planning to make a huge sale for the Christmas season. But 24 hours after, the largest retail mall in Abuja is down to rubbles. It was a sight so painful to watch as goods worth millions of naira were consumed by the inferno that sustained its temple for more than 5 hours.
We have about 13 trucks, four from the Federal Fire Service, four from the FCT. We have the NNPC here, Julius Berger is also here. Then Guards Brigade is also here, the Navy is also here. We work as a team. As long as there's a fire, we all work as a team. We've exhausted water from 32 different vehicles.
For any shop of this category, should have a fire truck, should have water truck available, should have emergencies cordoned off. Offices will be, instructions will be given for such offices to be made, stationed in the in such shops. Because no matter what, I know we do need more skills, and we could discuss towards even deploying men to be there, to be, you know, paid off by the management of this kind of stores.
Security agencies arrived in good time, so there was no how any hoodlum can loot anything. There was no looting. That is the situation. There was nothing like looting. All those things on the viral video were trolled to safety, and you can see.
Firefighters and other security agencies did their best to put the fire off. In the end, they were only able to salvage few items. Some, who pretended to be sympathetic and appeared to have come to help, ended up daring the fire to steal items. Some of them were arrested and whisked away by the police.
Mall, no matter what, no matter how small your investment is, there must be, you must factor in risk into it. The problem we are having is that we forget about risk elements. In anything you are doing, think about the risk element and then make provision for it. You can see from this building, we were able to detect that the accessibility of the building also hampers the operation. If there is a very big entrance that would be permanently meant for such purposes, when there is an emergency, you open it so that emergency workers can go in. The trucks could have gone in and then really work hard. But nevertheless, we commend them for doing what they have done.
During this period, we normally keep men on standby, and they were the ones that called out other security agencies, and they actually responded within 15 minutes. And I think this is commendable.
The raging fire spared nothing, including this money safe, with all the currency in it burnt to ashes. For these workers of the mall, the reality of being out of a job in January stares them in the face, with some unable to hide their emotions.
You can't quantify it. It's a loss that they have to take. It's a loss that every Nigerian have to take. It's a big loss because this is more like a neighborhood shopping mall. Everybody knows Nest. Their bread is good. Everything about Nest is perfect. You understand? So it hurt us. My friend has been crying so much. We don't even have any investments here, but we think about the businessmen and women that have investments in this, inside this place. A lot has gone down the flame, and if you look directly inside here, you could see that the wall is down. The roof is down. Everything is flat. For a lot of people, it's a black day. And for the owners of this property, I cannot begin to explain what they're going through. We all have been shopping here for years, you understand? So to come here and see this thing happening right now, it hurt us as very well.
For the management and staff of Next Cash and Carry, this is a bad way to end the year 2021.